We are now just 7 days away from WWE Super Showdown February 2020. It's kind of strange, I gotta say, the month, but this probably isn't gonna be the only Super Showdown of the year. Of course, the huge main event for the show, the Fiend Bray Wyatt defending the Universal Championship against the legendary Goldberg. And everyone wants to know, will the Fiend lose to Goldberg? Now, we know the Universal Championship can change hands in Saudi Arabia. It actually changed hands at the last Saudi show. Bray won the title from Seth Rollins the night of Halloween at the last Super Showdown. I think, obviously, this is a cool thing WWE did, but I don't think it's something they're going to duplicate just yet. I think The Fiend versus Goldberg, for me, it's a really big match. This is my childhood hero, Goldberg, versus the reason I watch WWE today, Bray Wyatt. And this is genuinely, for me, going to be a really, really good match. And I think the best thing about it is it hasn't been ruined. All we've had so far is promos. Of course, Goldberg was scheduled to be on SmackDown. It was like a satellite feed. We had the Funhouse interrupt. We've had a lot of talking, not a lot of action. And you're not bored of something already. Does that make sense? Nowadays with WWE, you kind of get bored of a rivalry. However, this Friday, SmackDown, well, you're next because Goldberg is coming to Phoenix, Arizona. Goldberg returns to the blue brand ahead of his Universal title match against The Fiend, Bray Wyatt. And I think this could be the first time we see these two actually physically interact. And I'm fine with that. I think it'll be perfectly fine. Now, if Goldberg does win the Universal title, the rumored matchup that everyone's talking about would be Goldberg versus Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. I think any other year, I think this would be perfectly fine. I think it's a good way to get the championship onto Roman. I think the diehard fans that attend WrestleMania would not want to see Goldberg go over Roman. I think people would actually be happy to see Roman Reigns win the Universal title. However, we all know that the rumored match for this year's WrestleMania is The Fiend versus Roman Reigns. And again, the rumored assumption is Roman will defeat Bray. Now, I personally don't want to see that, but it's kind of what Vince McMahon and WWE probably want to do. The Superman, Roman Reigns defeating the villain, the monster, the Fiend. It kind of does make sense. However, we might not even get this match. Back in October last year, Goldberg was asked who he'd want to work with, and he said, God, who wouldn't I like to face? I mean, Roman and Braun are two guys that I would like to test their mettle a little bit. Georgia against Georgia Tech, it's kind of built-in rivalry. Goldberg wants to face Roman. It's possible that Goldberg's only agreed to come back to WWE to face Roman eventually. But to get to that stage, he's got to face The Fiend first. Roman has come out before, literally just before the Royal Rumble, and basically mocked Goldberg on Twitter. Nothing to explain, Nick. It's a little piece of pad, so I don't break my hand on still great. I gotta perform like 48 weeks a year, man, so that would be stupid. It would be like headbutting a door before my match. Level of stupid. Anyway, have a good day, Nick. Basically mocking the fact that Goldberg suffered a concussion after he headbutted the door. And we also know that Roman Reigns wants the dream match against The Rock at next year's WrestleMania. Again, it's a match I definitely want to see. I think it's an important match to solidify Roman Reigns as the top guy to take out The Rock. Truth is, he's always going to be compared to The Rock because of the relatives, because WWE put that in our faces that night that Roman won the Royal Rumble. So I think to him to defeat The Rock would be a solid move for Roman. And I think if you're going to do that, you've got to give Roman a very good build for that Rock match. Have him go in as champ. Have him leave as champ. Does that mean he's got to win the belt at Mania though? However, when asked who he'd prefer to face for the Universal title at WrestleMania, between The Fiend, Bray Wyatt and Goldberg, Roman Reigns admitted he doesn't care. He simply wants to regain the title he never lost, as Reigns was forced to relinquish the title back in 2018 due to his second battle with leukemia. However, when it boils down to it, Reigns said he'd prefer a matchup against The Fiend. He said, "I mean, I just want my title, to be honest. Nobody took that title from me. I had to relinquish it due to circumstances. So I'll just prefer my title. Honestly, from a completely honest standpoint, I would much rather face The Fiend. He's busted his ass all year long." No offense to Goldberg, I think he's a great performer. He's a great superstar, but I'm into the future right now and helping out the guys who can be in the locker room with me. And there's no doubt that The Fiend has put a lot of work into what he's done. But as we all have, so like I said, it's my time now. We've had fun with that funhouse, but it's time to bring it home. So it's actually possible that Roman Reigns could be using his influence backstage, probably talking to Vince McMahon, saying, "Look, I don't think the Goldberg match is right. Let's have me versus Bray instead." I mean, that does kind of make sense. I kind of like what Roman's saying there, that this is a match and a rivalry that could go on. Why not book it? Now, there's no doubting that this Goldberg rivalry and feud actually makes a lot of sense, because look at what it's done for Bray. Bray's obviously the top guy in the company right now, and he's just worked last week on SmackDown with Hulk Hogan, okay, via satellite. But to have that promo, to have that segment with Bray Wyatt and Hulk Hogan, solidifies Bray Wyatt to a casual audience that probably have never been exposed to someone like Bray Wyatt for a long time. And also, if The Fiend does lose the belt at Super Showdown, who says he's not going to be scheduled for a match against someone like Sting? We know Sting is someone that Bray Wyatt himself wishes he could face at WrestleMania. It would make perfect sense that maybe WWE have signed Sting to this match and The Fiend's agreed to lose the championship so he can take part against Sting. I think this could be a cool outcome if, you know, The Fiend is going to lose at Super Showdown, to actually have him go on to WrestleMania, maybe even face someone like Killer Cross, someone that's just joined the WWE, that's to most casual WWE fans a complete stranger, and have him walk out, have him beat Killer Cross, or even have Killer Cross defeat The Fiend. You could really play some great stories on The Fiend having a completely different WrestleMania match this year. I like that. But there's also one more person who it could be: Matt Hardy. Now, if Matt Hardy is pulling the wool over all of our eyes and he's not going to AEW, he's not going to Impact Wrestling, etc., what if Matt Hardy, we got like, what, 6 weeks to build to it, comes back after Super Showdown, comes back, attacks The Fiend, comes back as part of the Funhouse, something, I don't know. But what if this is the match for WrestleMania? It would make a lot of sense. We know Bray and Matt Hardy are really close friends. We know they've got history together. And I genuinely think they could do something like that. So maybe if The Fiend doesn't retain the belt at Super Showdown, maybe it's not the end of the road just yet. I mean, you got to remember that Bray Wyatt is right now the top merchandise seller for WWE. And WWE's not going to throw that away anytime soon. Whether he's champion or not, they know when they're onto a good thing. And you can tell because they keep bringing out new merch. And I swear to God, every single day, and I love you guys for doing it, I get tagged on Twitter from people saying, "I've just bought this, I've just bought that, look what's just turned up." And I think that's also really interesting that it's still popular. I mean, look at Funhouse Bray. We saw him wrestle in December. Why would it be impossible for Funhouse Bray Wyatt to also have a match at WrestleMania? Hell, The Fiend Bray Wyatt could pull double duty. The Fiend could wrestle, whether it's for the championship or not, and maybe Bray Wyatt can wrestle, maybe even for the championship or not. There's so many possibilities that could still unfold in the 6 weeks after, like, today's date. Just makes sense. Now, the rumoured match will always be The Fiend versus Roman until Goldberg takes that title. I don't think that's going to happen, however. I gotta say, I think this WrestleMania match, we're all moaning right now about Goldberg winning the belt. We're all forgetting that, in fact, the high probability chance is that Roman Reigns will take that championship from The Fiend at WrestleMania anyway. Kind of a bit of a stick in the mud, isn't it, right? But I don't believe that Goldberg will defeat The Fiend. I think that Bray Wyatt will capture the win at Super Showdown, retain the championship, set up for WrestleMania. We're a couple of weeks away from Elimination Chamber, where we assume Roman Reigns is going to win, and that will start setting up the Roman versus the Fiend story. And I'm all for it. I think Goldberg, obviously, is a legend, coming back to do a show in Saudi Arabia, where we know they love the legends over there. It just makes a lot of sense. Let me know your thoughts, as you always do, in the comment section down below. Like the video, it really does help it rank up on YouTube. Subscribe to the channel if you are new. Share the video on social media so your friends can find it and come and have their say. And I'll, as always, see you next time. Peace!